This exhibition features the work of 30 artists from around the United States, Canada, and abroad, two of which came from Palestine, to look at the issue of artists and censorship with a particular emphasis on an unusual circumstance that was not very widely reported. In 1980, in Israel, an older law of 1967 was expanded to ban the use of the four colors of the Palestinian flag, red, white, green, and black, used in consort in any fashion whatsoever. Now, this meant art supplies, art, clothing, in any use of those four colors. This ban went on until 1993, during which time the Oslo Accords were promulgated and the ban was overturned. These 30 artists, contemporary artists, have created 49 pieces of work that reference this period. During that time, Palestinian artists boycotted Israeli art supplies. So they were making their own pigments out of flowers and mud. They were using old furniture that had paint on it that they would cut up and use for sculpture. They used anything they could find. This is called the Palestinian Protest Flag, and it's by an artist named Michaela Amato. And as you see, it doesn't look anything like a flag at all, and that's the whole idea. What she's done is she used colors that are not the right colors. They are the greens, the reds, the whites, the black, but not in the colors, the actual colors of the flag. Again, this is a remembrance of not being able to get pigments in part of the boycott. This piece by Andrew Courtney, it's a photograph, it's called Victory Garden, and it is vegetables in the shape of a Palestinian flag. Dr. Isaac was part of a committee to help Palestinians in the West Bank and Gaza get seeds for food. And he created a series of what they call victory gardens, very much based on the nomenclature of the victory gardens during the World Wars. He planted seeds and vegetables in these colors, and he was put in jail for 6 months because of this. We have a poem by Zaina Azam, our executive director here at the Jerusalem Fund, but also a well-known published poet.
Blue-green, watery globe, tugging to a red core. We are a distant comet, white cloud of unburnished rocks, frisking the heavens for an arc to earth, sea, home. Green-brown Palestine, cactus fruit and wild thyme, olive orchards, cypress trees. We travel on your mountaintops, tethered by voices from suitcases and the yaw of blackened keys. Blue-black night, silver stars of ancestors traveling a displaced orbit around a lost sun, repeating, when will we see the colors of our land? When will we land?
This piece by Palestinian artist John Halaka, who is a professor of art in San Diego, has three layers, and it may be difficult to see on film. First layer is there is a photograph taken by the artist of two farmers, a man and a woman. Over that, he has layered his ink drawings of cactus. And the juxtaposition of this with our poem is important because the poem also mentions the importance of cactus in terms of Palestinian life, culture, and farming. But if one manages to get an angle over here and does a backup, one can see a third face, a large face of a man peering through. And you can see his eyes, nose, and mouth. We have an artist, a Palestinian artist who lives in Canada. Her name is Najat El-Kari, and she's a porcelain artist, makes her own porcelain, and has a proprietary method for infusing the porcelain with art, with color. But her intent on all of these pieces is to showcase Palestinian embroidery patterns as a symbol of the continuation of Palestinian culture. So in her work, in her drawings, she draws them as if they were stitched. And all of the stitches that she includes in the pieces have names, and the stitches are part of the kind of work that would be found on Palestinian dress. Another little interesting point in Najat's charming work is that she buries the map of Palestine in all of her work. And so you see it here, hidden in the olive tree, the shape of the map of Palestine. We have here an artist from North Carolina named Nida Khalil, and she's made, she's a mosaic artist, and she's made these images of the famous Banksy balloon girl. In the original Banksy, there's a girl who's holding up a balloon. In her imagery, there is a reference to her childhood. This is one of the interesting stories about this show. When she was 8 years old, she was living in Palestine during the ban. And when she took a piece of her school notebook paper, drew the Palestinian flag on the paper, had her brother stationed outside on the roof to look out for the soldiers, and ran bravely outside and pasted this picture of the Palestinian flag on a post outside her home. So when this exhibition came about, she called me and said, I must be in this show because I actually lived this ban. This piece by Swiss artist Anne-Marie Feld says forbidden. And upon opening it, you see the colors imprisoned. On these walls, which by the way, are painted in the colors of the Palestinian flag, green, black, red, and white. We have a large piece by Palestinian artist Raji Cook. It's called Forbidden Colors. Raji's piece is made from cat food cans. The idea of the cat food cans is, again, reminiscences about the lack of art supplies and the ability of the Palestinian artists at that time to use found objects and create art with them. Two works by Noha Naqib, a Lebanese artist and architect, who examines the emergence of women. It's called Unveil the Forbidden, and she uses her architectural sensibility to create this collage where the woman is stepping out of her traditional background, flying her colors, and emerging as a strong individual. The piece on the top is by Andrew Courtney, the photographer who did the vegetables, and it is about a African Palestinian named Hawa, who is wearing, again, the colors, not necessarily in the proper tones, that's part of the idea. And he talks about, in this case also, a moment in 1990, when he was there, an Italian woman journalist was wearing a running suit of green, red, black, and white, jogging around the walled city, and was arrested by the Israeli police at the Jaffa Gate.